Okay, everybody, thank you so much for attending ISV's webinar. This time we're going to be focusing on South Africa, which is really exciting. This webinar will probably go for about 40 minutes, and I'll be talking everything you need to know about the volunteer project, a little bit about ISV as well, and also about the awesome adventure tour as well. We're going to start off. This is one of my favorite photos. This is from our very first time that we ran our South Africa program back in 2007. 2009, and it was just an outstanding success. So we're really, really happy to have that. This program is one of our strongest programs that we're running today. All right, so let's actually talk a little bit about the program. Who is ISV and what do we do? Well, we are actually the highest rated volunteer and adventure travel program for students. We've had nearly 21,000 students travel with us since 2002, and have come from over 800 colleges and universities, which is just fantastic. We are a really large organization because we have such an amazing reputation for quality and excellence, and students from all around the world decide that they want to travel with ISV and ISV alone. As a great example, we were selected last year as one of the top 10 volunteer organizations in the world by the US State Department, and last year we also received the Outstanding Project of the Year Award at the World Youth and Student Travel Conference. That's a fantastic testament to the amazing work that we do around the world with ISV. So let's talk a little bit about ISV in South Africa. We've been running programs since 2009, and it's grown to be our most popular country by far. When you think about it, it's not hard to understand why. You've got an incredible culture. You've got so many animals that we've all seen on the documentary channel, and this is a really great opportunity to really get up close and personal with them and really discover that incredible that incredible tribal feel that we see and have grown up with, about knowing what is Africa all about. This is your chance to get in there and learn it yourself. We have firm partnerships with local conservation and development groups in this. So we basically partner with grassroots organizations that are doing fantastic work in conservation or community work, and that actually allows us to really do some meaningful projects. Rather than just coming in and doing projects that mean nothing, we actually ask these communities and partner with them, what are your goals? How can we develop these sustainable projects so we make a true impact in this country? And you'll find that you're really going to be having the most effective volunteer experience you can, because we're doing work that the community needs, that the community wants, and we're doing it alongside the community, not just for the community as well. I do want to say that we have two different tours that we run. Our May through to September program is different through our November through to February program. That's because the weather patterns in South Africa vary quite a lot, so we make sure that we change our tour itinerary to make sure you get the best out of both seasons as well. Most of the people who are in this webinar right now are from Australia or New Zealand, and so we're going to be focusing on our November through to February itinerary. So let's talk a little bit about South Africa itself. As you can see, it's right down the bottom of the continent of Africa, and it's actually got two smaller countries inside it. That is Swaziland up in the top right, and also Lesotho as well. We actually have projects in Swaziland, which is great. We actually do a tour that goes all along the bottom of South Africa, from Cape Town all the way from to Port Elizabeth as well. So you're really going to get to see that incredible area. That's called the Garden Route. And then we're actually going to fly up to the northern part of South Africa, where we're actually going to go to Kruger National Park, all the way up there in the top near Mozambique. All right, so South Africa is a pretty incredible country. It's known as the Rainbow Nation. It has 11 different languages. It's got the third highest level of biodiversity in the world. And Kruger National Park, one of the areas that we go and visit, actually supports the greatest variety of African wildlife species on the continent, which is great. But as you know, South Africa has had a pretty turbulent history. Up until recently, it was under the apartheid regime, where people of different races were segregated. It has some incredible conservation issues in the fact that land has been cleared for farming, and the increasing influence of humans in cities has meant that animals have had less and less of a place to live, and their habitats have been destroyed. And so a lot of these animals, which are so famous, are highly endangered. And so it's really an amazing opportunity for our volunteers to get out there and help make a difference. So let's talk a little bit about the ISV program. It is a 2-week volunteer project followed by a 2-week adventure tour. there was a question before saying how long does the program last, and you can choose to do just a two-week volunteer project, or you can choose to do the four-week program that is volunteer and adventure, and we also have an additional five-day excursion at the end that is, we call the Wild Africa excursion, where you go to Zambia and Botswana as well, so I'll tell you more about that. But let's start off by talking a little bit about the volunteer projects, as they are absolutely fantastic. We have programs in environmental management. Now, as you know, the incredible diversity of animals in Africa is truly the biggest draw card, and is a unique opportunity for you to volunteer in the beautiful country of Swaziland, which is inside the borders of South Africa and also in South Africa itself. We're going to be doing a range of things within African game parks that include data collection, monitoring, tracking, radio tracking, repairing fences, basically monitoring these parks so that they have these animals have the best opportunity to survive and grow in their numbers. An interesting fact is that in South Africa, more land is protected through private reserves than through national parks. So that means individual landowners who host these reserves need help in protecting the animals that live on them. So some of the species that you'll be directly encountering are the marabou stork, bats and tortoises. We're going to be doing some direct conservation projects with them, but then you're also going to be doing tracking of animals and larger animals using radio transmitters, using daily observations and recording the data. And so this is a great opportunity for you to get in contact and up close and personal with some of the larger African animals such as the white rhino, the African elephant, and really experience them in their natural habitat, which is so exciting. As a volunteer, you're going to help professional researchers collect important data on specific plants and animals. And the reality of what this means is that you'll receive specialized training in data collection, which is critical to conservation management. So the people who are making policies actually have the data to support the policy that's being made. And in turn, you're going to learn an incredible amount about African wildlife, about conservation and scientific research. So after training, each day you're going to go and venture into the reserve, and you're going to spend a number of hours making observations and recording the information that you gather. Some of the activities that you're going to be involved in include things like conducting bird counts at sunrise, checking pitfall traps to record insect diversity, because we need to check all levels within the ecosystem, from the smallest insects up to the largest animals, because an ecosystem is more than just big, cute animals. We're going to do things like radio tracking tortoises in their native habitats. We're going to be measuring data on marabou storks, and also observing patterns and behaviors of endangered species such as the white rhino, which is highly endangered. There's only a few thousand left in the world, and you are going to be working with them, which is great. Now, the types of decisions that are made from the data that you collect vary widely. Reserve managers need to know if the populations of these animals are declining or increasing, which habitat is being used more often and why, and what what the predator to prey ratio is, so we know whether the ecosystem is in balance. You're also going to be looking at things like how much elephant damage is occurring in areas, which herbivores are grazing in specific grasslands. So herbivores are things like zebras and giraffes, as you see here. What small animals and mammals are in certain habitats given the presence of larger mammals, and which species are flourishing and which are struggling to survive. So you're really going to be doing some fantastic research projects. There are many things to take into consideration with wildlife management and habitat restoration, and this is why it's really important to have accurate data. So your man hours out there in the field are really going to go towards creating specific environmental policy. Now, the tasks do require dedication and hard work. However, the rewards are big, and you're going to be surrounded by a variety of African animals, so buffalo, antelope, zebra, cheetahs, lions. There's so many great animals out there. Don't worry, you won't be up right next to lions there. We make sure that everything and every interaction you have is completely safe. Now, you'll be sitting in the heart of these reserves, and you'll be surrounded by the sounds, the smells, and the sights of the African bush, and you'll be captivated by the incredible sunsets and the night skies, and it's just incredible being woken up to a chorus of birds or hearing lions off in the distance as they finish off their hunt in the night. Or even as you're working right next to giraffes and zebra, I don't think any of your friends will be able to say they have an opportunity like this, and this is something that you can do during your summer. Every drive to and from your work site, between your accommodation and your work site, is going to be filled with animals like elephants, hippos, antelopes, and wildebeest. So this really is an experience not to be forgotten. So in summary, you're going to be doing things like working in the African game reserves in South Africa and Swaziland. You're going to be collecting data on animals to help the long-term management through radio tracking, through observation and structured research. We're going to be doing fence maintenance, animal patrols, and working along the famous African animals like buffalo, rhinos, zebras, lions, and leopards. You'll be in the African bush for 2 whole weeks, and you'll be doing everything from small mammal research to bird counts, habitat assessments, and even big game counts as well. So here's some great photos that our students have taken while on their trip. Here you can see we found an injured rhino that we had to assist the rangers as they were cleaning out some of the wounds. Working with zebra here who was also injured that we needed to help rehabilitate. Some antelope there that you'll be getting up close with. Here there's some bird eggs that we were helping to protect. Again, there's a vulture who were doing some work with some vultures and helping tag and track the vultures. And there's a, I'm not sure what's in that cage, but it's obviously something that's being released back into the wild. Here we're making some pitfall traps, and these are used to basically bury into the ground, and they collect insects, and so we can measure what insects are in the habitats as well. And there's our one of our volunteers helping tag a stork, so we can monitor and track the population of birds in the areas as well. And you're going to see plenty and plenty of awesome animals like giraffes and of course elephants as well, which is just an incredible experience. I'm so jealous of anyone that actually goes to South Africa. I've always wanted to see these animals. Here is the next side of what we do in South Africa. It's our community development programs. Without a doubt, these are the cutest kids you'll ever interact with, and the communities are just so inspiring and so amazing. They have this real love of rhythm and dance, and they'll teach you about their culture and will love hearing about your culture and learning about what you do and how your culture differs from theirs. By far, the greatest issue facing South Africa is poverty, and this ongoing issue has really marginalized millions of South Africans. The result is that there are many needs, such as access to quality medical care, housing, electricity, food and employment, even education, and these are not being met. ISV really focuses on sustainable community development projects that really seek to meet the needs of the present without jeopardizing the needs of the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. So our volunteers actually assist local organizations to improve community infrastructure where the benefits are far-reaching. Examples would include things like construction of schools and classrooms. We've even constructed a medical clinic, which I'll talk about soon, public transit shelters, community gardens. We've developed school playgrounds, sporting fields. We've planted fruit trees along main roads. We've helped paint educational murals, and we've also improved access to portable water as well. There are things in South Africa called townships. These are essentially very, very, very poor communities. They're very rich in culture, but very poor in basic infrastructure. Houses are basically made from scrap metal. Children are running around with no shoes on their feet. There's no electricity. There's no running water. These are basic things that we all take for granted. But the people who are working, living inside these communities are just trying on a day-to-day basis just to get by. And it's an amazing experience to come into this community, work with these people, and help them improve their own lives. So we'll be working to do things like pouring cement, laying bricks, making educational play equipment, planting seeds, and working on projects that really do make a difference. Beyond building new structures, our community development projects really hope to increase the capacity within people and community to support themselves through income generation, enhance community identity, and also education. Projects like community gardens and setting up market stalls, teaching local community members construction and gardening skills, all help to build human capacity, and it helps these communities take control of their own future. Volunteers are given the unique opportunity to interact with these local communities and the gorgeous children, just like you see in front of us here. So imagine seeing living conditions that you never believed existed, and then 2 weeks later, you can walk away knowing that you have made a significant positive contribution to the members of this community. Moreover, you're going to be learning about the amazing cultures within the nation of South Africa. As I said, there are 11 different languages. Life post-apartheid is so different to before. There's so much more freedom and liberation, but there are still ongoing issues such as poverty and HIV and AIDS, which really need issues that need addressing. So some of the great achievements that you can be part of is of many and varied. Many communities have limited access to education, especially for younger children like you see here. So ISV volunteers have constructed an Educare Centre in the local community where we now hold classes for children of various ages. This centre was created entirely from recycled materials and is fully transportable, which is great, so it can go from community to community. ISV volunteers also put their creativity to good use and painted the inside of schools with colourful murals and really made these places an incredible place for children to develop and learn. Perhaps my favourite achievement was only within the last few years, ISV volunteers completed a medical clinic in a remote village in South Africa. This has provided medical care for over 2,000 people who would have otherwise gone without, as they had no means to travel so far to the other villages to access medical care. Imagine if you get sick and the nearest village was hundreds and hundreds of kilometres away and you had no way to get there. It would have been a terrible situation. But due to this construction and the fact that ISV volunteers have built this clinic, the local government has now actually committed to having a free doctor who visits the community regularly. Because of this, diseases like HIV, AIDS and tuberculosis are greatly being diminished within this community, and this is such a benefit to these people. Some other things that we've done is we've built jungle gyms for children so that they have a safe area in which they can play and develop. And we've also supported employment situations. Unemployment is such a huge problem in South Africa. It's essential for local communities to find sustainable income that they can generate. Things like community gardens and market stalls are a fantastic way for local communities to feed themselves, as it will generate extra income. So ISV volunteers have built four different market stalls and also helped maintain several community gardens. With ISV's help, our partner organizations in the small community have approached small business owners and restaurants and also encouraged them to buy local organic produce from the community. So it really does create a sustainable source of income for everyone, which is great. Now, the other side of our community development programs is actually working with children. So we've got the infrastructure development, but we've also got the children's education. Poverty, HIV, AIDS, broken families, inadequate housing, bad school facilities and other necessities are just some of the barriers that millions of South African children face in their struggle for a better life. Education is the most powerful vehicle that can transform societies and break through the cycles of poverty and disease. So education empowers people so they can live healthier and more prosperous lives, where people can make choices about their future and in doing so shape the course of their own community. Because of this, ISV is working to assist local organizations to fill the gaps left by government systems in selected communities. So basically we're helping educate kids who would otherwise receive nothing. So ISV supports a number of children's programs in South Africa where we're reaching out to children who are poor, orphaned and vulnerable. These children really need positive influences in their life, with so many affected by broken homes, prostitution, alcoholism, absent parents and even AIDS. The youngest children in kindergarten really benefit from your attention as a volunteer, as you'll be showing affection, you'll be practicing basic English, you'll be reading to them, you'll be playing games, you'll be teaching sport, and you'll just be letting kids be kids, which is just amazing, and they'll be so inspired by you and you'll just fall in love with them. Volunteers who are slightly older will receive more English practice as you interact with them on a deeper level, and they'll receive after-school activities such as music and dance. We actually have a program that inspires children to stay off drugs and alcohol through music and dance. And it's an incredibly powerful program that you're absolutely going to love. It's really important to motivate children to spend their time wisely and safe in a positive environment. And you're going to be doing this by interacting with them and showing them the potential that they can reach. And in doing so, you're going to basically help steer these kids away from the path of gangs, drugs and alcohol. And these are things that are very common in poorer areas. As you probably know, HIV and AIDS is still very much a common problem in South African communities, and it's often a taboo issue. It's not talked about. So we have a really exciting project that supports educating teenagers about disease prevention. And these are programs that are going to last, the impact will be felt for generations. The children of South Africa are so friendly, and they love connecting with our ISV volunteers, and that's what really makes these community programs so rewarding. You really won't want to leave. Our community programs have a great mix of children's programs and community infrastructure development. So, as I said, you're going to be working with children. You'll be providing much-needed infrastructure, education, school and classroom building, HIV/AIDS education, and this incredible cultural interaction. It's just an experience that is absolutely going to change your life. It's great. Here's some photos of the projects that you could be working on. So these are the type of kids that you'll be working with. They'll just be running up to you, jumping all over you. It's so much fun. Here's one of our volunteers actually participating in some sport education programs in the local school, which is great. We really do try and harness the talents and abilities of our volunteers so they can put their own skills into practice. Here's our volunteers who are helping roll out a really powerful program on getting tested for tuberculosis, diabetes, and high blood pressure. And these are the type of things that if we can help spread awareness about these issues, then we can avoid them in the future as well. Here's some of the beautiful kids that you could be working with in one of our schools. Again, look at the smiles on their faces. They're just absolutely magical. Here's a computer lab that ISV helped fund and build. And it's really an incredible project because this community would have had no access to the outside world. Their entire knowledge was what was within this community. And with the help of ISV and other local organizations, we've been able to really support the education and development of these kids. And they're realizing that there is so much more out there and that they can realize their own potential as well. Is one of our community projects where we're working at a school to help basically build gardens, running water, drainage, make these areas a fun and safe place to be. And there's one of our volunteers just having a bit of a break with the kids out there, which is great. Now, one of the questions that popped up before the webinar was, are any of the program costs actually donated to the conservation or the community efforts? The answer is a lot of the program fees go towards supporting the host organizations. We work to support many of the initiatives that they have. If there are special projects that actually are requesting additional funding, in many cases ISV does provide funding for those. But we don't actually give money to directly to the communities because that's not a sustainable practice. Just handing money over doesn't actually solve any of the problems. What we're more focused on is building a system that will allow for sustainable income generation, for development in the future, and for ongoing practices. So we will put money in towards programs and projects that we believe are going to have a sustainable impact, but we don't just hand over blank checks because that has the ability to get misused. I hope that answers that question. Here's a great a playground that our ISV volunteers built. Can you imagine being part of the group that built that? You're sawing the wood, you're putting in the nails, you're working with the kids. You see those blue bins in the background? They're recycle bins and trash bins. We put bins throughout a community that had nothing. And we took this community from an area where people would be throwing rubbish wherever they wanted to a beautiful area where kids can play safely without having rubbish in their way as well. Here's one of our volunteers finishing off some painting with handprints of the inside of the school that we were working on. And, of course, here's some of our volunteers working, having a great time with some of the kids. It's great. And I just really like this photo. So as I was saying, the kids love interacting with you, and they're really going to have a great time learning about you and discovering things like even how to take a picture with a camera and whatnot. For anyone that is a medical, nursing, or health student, I've got a really exciting opportunity that I want to talk about. We've recently launched a brand new program delivering home health care in Cape Town. We're basically supporting a grassroots organization that is a collection of 12 people who are passionate about health and medicine. And they've actually started an incredible project where they're visiting families and elderly people who are too sick to leave their houses, or they can't afford to go see a doctor, and so they do routine visits over to people's houses to deliver healthcare and assistance. So we've launched a brand new skilled project for anyone who is studying nursing, health, or medicine who would like to gain who would like to gain experience in this field. What's fantastic about this project is not only will you be gaining experience yourself, but this organization and these members really benefit from you sharing your own knowledge. What is the latest in nursing practices, in medical practices? So you're going to be able to share what you've learned at university, and they're going to be able to share with you what the reality is out on the ground as well. Anyone who's interested in signing up for the skilled project, all you need to do is on your application or your agreement, just put medical project under promo code, and we can put you onto that program. It really is an incredible project that's going to allow you to get a fantastic experience doing grassroots medical care with the people who need it most. And anyone who's looking to get into med school or any further, it's obviously going to look like a fantastic experience on your resume. So here's a couple of pictures here, just in the clinic. One of our volunteers out there in one of the homes. You will be working alongside one of the professionals, and your level of involvement will actually depend on your skill level as well. You'll have some great interaction with the kids on this project as well. And there's an example of the office of the medical clinic. They actually do all their work. They're based out of a shipping container. And so it's really important that they do get out and work in the community. All right, let's talk about the adventure tour. This is absolutely sensational. There is so much that we cram into this tour. For the next 2 weeks, you are just going to have the most mind-blowing experience. I'm going to go through the itinerary on a day-by-day basis. So on day one, we're going to arrive in Jeffreys Bay, and we're going to travel to Port Elizabeth. We arrive in Port Elizabeth on a plane, and then we're actually going to drive south to Jeffreys Bay. We're going to unwind with the tour orientation, and then we're going to have a traditional braai, which is a barbecue, a South African barbecue. We're going to have a bonfire on the beach, and you're just going to experience how beautiful Jeffreys Bay is. The next day, we're going to have an action-packed day where we start with surf lessons in the morning. And for those of you that don't know, Jeffreys Bay is a surfer's paradise. It's one of the most famous surfing locations in the world. The afternoon, you've got some free time where you can soak up the rays or learn some new surf skills. And then in the late afternoon, the experts are going to show you how they surf on what they call super tube breaks, which are huge, huge waves. On day three, we're actually going to travel from Jeffreys Bay to the Sitsikama National Park. Here we're going to do a really fun treetop canopy tour. So in the morning, we're going to stop off at some surf shop outlets before we drive to Storms River and explore what's called the Utaniqua Yellowwood Trees. This is a really incredible location where the best way to see the trees is to hook yourself up to a cable, and we're going to take a flying fox through the canopy. We're going to travel between multiple platforms, and you're going to go zipping through the trees. It's so much fun. But the good thing is it's not just an adventure activity. You're really going to be learning about forest ecology from the local guides. And in the evening, we're going to be staying in a colonial village in a quaint little town right on the Storms River, which is great. The next day is a pretty awesome day. We are going to go on a hike of the rugged coastline in the Tsitsikama National Park. It's going to be a three-hour hike right on the ocean's edge. We're going to get to a waterfall that flows right onto the sea, and we're going to swim in a really beautiful tannin-colored pool at the base of the waterfall. It's a really incredible area where a forest actually meets the sea, and there's a waterfall there. Which is great. Now, for those of you who are ultimate thrill seekers, you're actually going to get to try bungee jumping. This isn't included in the price of the program. It is an additional expense, but it's just an unbelievable experience. It's actually the highest bridge bungee jump in the world. That's a huge 216 meters. Now, if you don't want to do that, that's fine. There's plenty of other activities that you can do in the local area. But if I were you, I would watch all of my friends terrify themselves if they jump off that ledge. All right, so the next day, guys, we are traveling to Cape Town. We're going to basically travel on the southern coast of South Africa along what's known as one of the most scenic stretches of coastline in the world. Here we're going to get ready to stay in the exciting city of Cape Town, where we'll actually stay for 5 days. Cape Town is going to be our base. It's an incredible city. There's so much we're going to do there. On day six, we're actually going to have a cultural day. We're going to learn about the history and cultural diversity within Cape Town. We're going to go through a variety of activities. We're going to start with a guided walking tour of the city highlights, visiting things like museums, District 6, and a slave lodge, which will tell you all about Cape Town's really disturbing past. In the afternoon, we're going to go visit the oldest township where you get to meet local people, such as these lovely ladies here, and you really get a feel for the local culture. In the evening, we're going to have what's called the Mayo African Experience, which includes a buffet dinner, traditional African dancing and music as well, so everyone gets to get into that rhythm. All right, on the next day, we're going to have the thrill of a lifetime as we climb up Table Mountain. So you can catch a cable car or you can climb up the mountain, and we're basically going to abseil 110 meters down a 1,000-meter cliff face, which is pretty huge. 1,000 meters, that's a kilometer high. It's an incredible experience, as you can see. And that lady right there on the left, that's Shona. She is our South African coordinator. She's the one that set this entire program up, and she'll make sure that you have an amazing time. All right, so on the next day, we are going to go on a nature tour. This is an incredible day where we're going to go to the world-famous Cape Point, which is where most people say the Atlantic and the Indian Oceans meet. Here, we're going to swim in beautiful turquoise waters and pristine white sand beaches, and we're going to take a boat cruise to a seal colony in a place called False Bay to see thousands and thousands of Cape fur seals. You can see how many there are there. It's great. We're then going to take a hike to the Cape of Good Hope, and we're going to have some fish and chips in a quaint seaside village in the tiny village of Simonstown. Now, one of the highlights has got to be at the end of the day, we're actually going to go to a penguin colony and have some great photo opportunities with some African penguins. The next day is a travel day. The next day is a free day where you actually get to see some of Cape Town's highlights. This is one of my favorite photos. It was submitted in the photo competition last year, and it shows how vivid and bright parts of Cape Town can be. It looks like an incredible area that you can go and explore and have a great time exploring Cape Town. All right, so the next day, day 10, is a travel day where we're going to actually have a domestic flight early in the morning all the way up to Johannesburg, which is up in the north. Northeast of South Africa, and we're going to go to the beautiful area of Blyde Canyon, which has incredible views, and we're going to spend a couple of days in Blyde Canyon. The next day, we're going to go kalufing. Kalufing is just like canyoning, but that's the South African word for it. We're going to essentially rock climb. We're going to go cliff jumping. We're going to go waterfall sliding. We're going to spend an entire day hiking through this forest, just exploring the beautiful surroundings within Blyde Canyon. One of the best things about Blyde Canyon is the views. If you can have a look at that, it is just an incredible place to be. It's just amazing. So you're going to get your cameras ready as we go through what's called the panoramic route of the Drakensberg Escarpment. That's this area right here. We're going to stop and look at the beautiful rock formations. And as we head up to Kruger National Park, when we get to Kruger, we're actually going to have a sunset game drive. So this is an opportunity for us to go and see the African animals during the sunset, which is going to be a very different experience from during the day. So the night drive offers much more suspense as you see animals at night, and it's just an incredible experience. So day 13, we are still in Kruger National Park. We're looking for animals such as elephants, such as rhinos, hippos, springboks, lions, giraffes, and it's just amazing. You're going to have lunch in the park, and later we'll return back to our accommodation for dinner. On the last day, guys, we go back to Johannesburg, and for those of you that have the Wild Afro excursion, we continue our adventure with five more days. But Kruger National Park is just an incredible place. It's the largest national park in Africa, and just look at all the animals that are there. You've got your elephants, so many different elephants. This is one of my favorite photos of a hippo. It's just fantastic. So that's the adventure tour. For those of you that didn't get enough of South Africa, you can join ISV for what we call the Wild Africa Excursion. This is five incredible days immediately after the four-week program finishes. And you'll spend the first night at our hostel in Johannesburg before we have the orientation meeting and start our excursion. So day one, we actually go from Johannesburg to Livingstone in Zambia. Zambia is the adventure capital of the world, and it's home to the incredible Victoria Falls. This afternoon, we're going to get acquainted, and you're going to take an incredible tour of Victoria Falls. And some of you may choose to get up in one of these light planes and actually take an air trip over the falls, which is amazing. On day three, we're going to go to Kobe National Park, which has the highest density of animals in all of Africa. We're going to enjoy a river cruise where you can spot hippos cruising in the water. You can see elephants bathing and playing in the river and crocodiles sunbathing on the riverbanks. This is a fantastic image right here, our tour leader, Tris, with a bunch of elephants right behind him, which is great. This is wildlife viewing heaven in the afternoon, as there are animals everywhere, and we're going to do evening game drives again, and we're going to finish with dinner under the stars as we go camping in the park, which is just great. The next day, we're going to have more of Kobe National Park as we go continue to explore it, and then we're going to head back to Livingstone in Zambia. On day five, we actually have a free day, and this is an amazing opportunity to take advantage of the many different things that you can do in the area. You could choose to flying over more falls. You could have a lion encounter at a sanctuary. We could go whitewater rafting or abseiling. These are all at an additional cost, but they're things that you definitely will want to do. And we finish the night with interactive African drumming as we have a Zambian feast. So that's a bit about the program, guys. Let's talk about the cost. The cost of the program for the four-week project and tour in Australian dollars is $3,495. It's a little bit higher for New Zealand, obviously, with the exchange rates. If you want to do just the two-week project, you can do the two-week project, and that's $1,995 Australian dollars. Domestic flights from Sydney, Melbourne, and Auckland tend to range from $2,700 to $3,500 or thereabouts. Those details are up on our website right now. We have domestic airfare for anyone doing the four-week project, as we do need to fly from Cape Town all the way up to Johannesburg, and that's an additional $495. If you're doing a two-week volunteer project only, that doesn't require that domestic flight, as you'll be doing projects in and around the Cape Town area. So you will not require that flight. Now, if those of you who want to do the optional activity package, that's going to be roughly $335. The price is still being determined. The optional activity package is essentially a package of activities that people choose to do on their free days. So there's five activities included on your tour. And during a free day, while everyone's chilling out, you might choose to take up additional surfing lessons, or there might be extensions on current activities, or it might be the evening game drive is included in that. So most students do end up taking up the optional activity package as well. And then you've got the Wild Africa excursion, five awesome days in Zambia, and checking out Kobe National Park in Victoria Falls, and that's going to be $1,335 as well. All right, guys, if you have any other questions, or if you want to want anything else answered, please do type them in now. I'll be stopping this webinar recording soon, but I'll stay online to actually answer questions. Make sure you visit our Facebook page. We have over 23,000 fans on there, and we've got heaps of videos on YouTube as well. It's really been a pleasure to talk to you about South Africa. If you haven't applied already, do apply today, isvolunteers.org. Get a bunch of friends going over with you. It's an incredible experience. It will absolutely change your life. I'm going to stop the recording now, but we will stay online, and I'll start just answering some questions.